But for now, this is really fun too. Today's our first flannel board story, and I'm super excited about that. Awesome. Well, we're going to do what we always do to get started and sing our Storytime song. You ready, Miss Keisha?
I'm ready.
All right, here we go.
We clap and say hello. We clap and say hello. With our friends at Storytime, we clap and say hello. We stomp and say hello. We stomp and say hello. With our friends at Storytime, we stomp and say hello. We wave and say hello. We wave and say hello. With our friends at Storytime, we wave and say hello.
Once there was a peddler who sold cats, but he was not like any ordinary peddler, carrying his wares on his back. He carried them on top of his head. First, he had his own checked cap. Then, a bunch of gray caps. Then, a bunch of brown caps. Then a bunch of blue calves. And on the very top, a bunch of red calves.
Ooh.
My favorite artist. He walked up and down the streets, holding himself very straight so as not to upset his calves. As he went along, he called, "Caps! Caps for sale! 50 cents a cap!" One morning, he couldn't sell any caps. He walked up and down the street, calling, "Caps! Caps for sale! 50 cents a cap!" But nobody wanted to buy any caps that morning. Nobody wanted to even buy a red cap. He began to feel very hungry, but he had no money for lunch. "I think I'll go for a walk in the country," he said. And he walked out of town, slowly, slowly, so as not to disturb his cats. He walked for a long time until he came to a great big...
a tree.
This is a nice place for a rest, he thought.
Mm-hmm.
He sat down very slowly under the tree, leaned back little by little against the tree trunk, so as not to disturb his cats on his head. Then he put up his hand to feel if they were straight. First was his own checked cap. Then the
gray cap.
Yes, then the
brown cap.
And then the
red cap.
And then on the very top were
red
the
caps.
Red. They were all there. So he went to sleep. It's okay to make a mistake. I can't be buying the canvas. So he slept for a very long time. When he woke up, he was refreshed and rested. Before standing, he felt with his hand to make sure his caps were all in the right place. But all he felt was his own checked cap. He looked to the right of him. No cap. He looked to the left. No caps. He looked to the back of him. No caps. He looked behind the tree. No caps. And then he looked up in the tree. And what do you think he saw? On every branch sat a
monkey.
Let's count the monkeys. We have
one, two.
Oh, monkey down. Three,
four.
Five.
Six.
Seven.
A lot of monkeys.
So on every branch sat a monkey. And on every monkey there was a gray
hat.
Or brown. Or a blue. Finally, he spoke to them. "You monkeys, you," he said, shaking his finger. "You give me back my caps." But the monkeys only shook their finger at him and said, "So this made the peddler angry. He shook both of his hands at them and said, "You monkeys, you, you give me back my caps." But the monkeys only shook both of their hands back at him and said,
three gray.
And then the brown cats.
Three brown cats.
Blue. Yes. And on the very tip top were the
red. My favorite. It was awesome.
If you have not signed up yet for summer reading, go to our website, rpl.org, or our Facebook page. You're there right now. You can find all the information you need to do summer reading from home. All right, you guys ready to do our closing song? Let's get our five little fish ready.